Hi and welcome to episode 10 of this season's Montenegrin vlog. The girls are down having a swim in the lake, and I've spent most of this morning perspiring on the balcony doing some work. So yeah, we'll go down and join them, get in the shade, and I'll have an iced tea. I'm getting really to like iced tea, although I'm led to believe they're not all that healthy. Just thought I'd take this opportunity while I'm walking down the hill, cricket still, to ask myself the question, why is it I always come to sunny places when I burn like a lobster and the heat really gets to me? I mean, when I was a young man, I was a soldier. We used to go to some crazy hot places, and I always used to find it very uncomfortable. I don't know why. I don't really perspire a lot in the heat, which is crazy. I do, like other people, but not all that much. And in the winter, when I'm in the snow and freezing, I perspire a lot then. Bit of a freak. But how do you cope with the sun and the heat? Especially people who are watching in India, people who are watching in Australia. Do you just go out for so many hours a day and then hide for the rest of it? How do you cope with the heat? Tam just loves it. She could, I think she could live in Dubai. Having said that, when we first went together for a long weekend in Dubai, she was saying, let's go and walk everywhere. It only took her about 5 minutes, and she was in an air-conditioned taxi. Yeah, the heat, a question. So yeah, me and heat. Stairs. Stairs always means fitness of one sort or another. Just walked through Perchan and I've got to the big cathedral, and I've just walked up all the steps, and there are three people, artists, who are honing their skills with oils on canvas, I think. And when I was walking up the steps, I went back to thinking about what I was talking about at the start of today's vlog, which isn't really about Montenegro. It's more about heat and me and fitness and all the rest of it. And I've just thought, you know, I'm really lucky to be able to do what I do, not get too much out of breath. My knees are cracking a little bit now, but I am getting on. So yeah, when you come here and you take pauses and breaks and you look at the sea, and you look at the peaceful way that people in this part of Montenegro live, there's no hustle and bustle, there's no London, there's no Berlin, there's no Brooklyn. There are cruisers saying that they're leaving KOTOR, though. No, honestly, it just made me feel that you know, I'm really happy where I am, what I do, and I'm lucky to be able to do what I do. So if I get a little bit out of breath, if I'm carrying a little bit too much weight, if I go as red as a lobster, what the heck? I think I should just be me. But I do go through these phases a lot, and I ask myself these questions quite a lot, as I'm sure you do as well. So how do you cope when you get these, I won't say depressions, but these little times when you're doubting, you know, am I as slim as what I used to be and all the rest of it? I don't know. Anyway, maybe it's been a nonsense vlog, but you stuck this long, so thank you very much indeed for sticking with me this long. If you'd like to give us a thumbs up for the for this season of the Montenegro vlogs in particular, and of course An Englishman in the Balkans, the whole channel, that would be really great. And when you comment, if you wouldn't mind commenting on this, just let us know where you're from. I know we've got people from India, we've got people from Canada, people from Australia, quite a few people from Bosnia and Herzegovina and wider Balkans, but I'm trying to build a bigger audience, so if you can let us know, I will give you a shout out. Yeah, good, thanks. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe. I will catch you on the next vlog. Stay safe.